seem to be good.
Welcome, everyone, to our Eucharistic celebration of the Solemnity of the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Out of respect for the liturgy and those around you, please silence your phones at this time. We continue to honor the COVID-19 guidelines outlined by the Archdiocese of San Antonio in regards to Mass and other liturgical celebrations in response to the recommendations from the Center for Disease Control and Prevention. We ask that you pay close attention to the direction of our ushers, as they will be your guides throughout the Mass, during Communion, and at the end of Mass. Thank you for your patience and assistance. Please stand as we begin our celebration.
this morning. Of course, we celebrate the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Raised body and soul into God's glory, Mary takes her place in heaven. We rejoice with the Lord's highly favored daughter with our opening hymn.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, I welcome you all to this Eucharistic celebration. And today, the Church is celebrating the Assumption of Our Lady into heaven with her body and soul. And normally, we have many feasts throughout the year, especially in the liturgical year. Whenever we are celebrating the feast of a saint, we are celebrating their feast day on their death day. And for the Church, it is the birthday of the saint in heaven. And that is the reason the Church celebrates the feast of any saint on their death day, which means the birthday of the saint in heaven. And so today, the Church is celebrating the Assumption of Our Lady, which is the spiritual birthday of our mother. It's not physical birthday, spiritual birthday of our mother in heaven. And we are given assurance that Mother Mary is there for us, who is always praying. And during this Holy Mass, let us thank the Lord for the gift of Mother Mary to each and every one of us as our spiritual mother. And for the time that we have failed in our lives, let us ask the Lord for pardon and peace. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous faults. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, our Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and the earth is
let us pray. Almighty our living God, who assumed the Immaculate Virgin Mary, the mother of your Son, body and soul into heavenly glory, grant, we pray, that always attentive to the things that are above, we may merit to be sharers of her glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns within the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated.
The first reading is a reading from the book of Revelation. God's temple in heaven was open, and the ark of his covenant could be seen in the temple. A great sign appeared in the sky, a woman clothed with the sun, with the moon beneath her feet, and on her head a crown of 12 stars. She was with child and wailed aloud in pain as she labored to give birth. Then another sign appeared in the sky. It was a huge red dragon with 7 heads and 10 horns, and on its head were 7 diadems. Its tail swept away a third of the stars in the sky and hurled them down to the earth. Then the dragon stood before the woman about to give birth to devour her child when she gave birth. She gave birth to a son, a male child, destined to rule all the nations with an iron rod. Her child was caught up to God and his throne. The woman herself fled into the desert, where she had a place prepared by God. Then I heard a loud voice in heaven say, "Now have salvation and power come, and the kingdom of our God, and the authority of his anointed one." The word of the Lord.
Thanks
Thanks be to God.
The second reading is a reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. For since death came through man, the resurrection of the dead came also through man. For just as in Adam, all die, so too in Christ shall all be brought to life, but each one in proper order. Christ, the first fruits, then, at his coming, those who belong to Christ. Then comes the end, when he hands over the kingdom to his God and Father, when he has destroyed every sovereignty and every authority and power. For he must reign until he has put all his enemies under his feet. The last enemy to be destroyed is death, for he subjected everything under his feet. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Gospel may that touch your hearts and make you worthy. You are the Father and of the Son of the Holy Spirit.
Mary is taken up to heaven. A chorus. Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Mary set out and traveled to the hill country in haste to a town of Judah, where she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the infant leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth, filled with the Holy Spirit, cried out in a loud voice and said, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And how does this happen to me, that the mother of my Lord should come to me? For at the moment the sound of your greeting reached my ears, the infant in my womb leaped for joy. Blessed are you who believe that what was spoken to you by the Lord would be fulfilled." And Mary said, "My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has looked upon his lowly servant. From this day all generations will call me blessed. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. He has mercy on those who fear him in every generation. He has shown the strength of his arm and has scattered the proud in their conceit. He has cast down the mighty from their thrones and has lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty. He has come to the help of his servant Israel, for he has remembered his promise of mercy, the promise he made to our fathers, to Abraham and his children forever." Mary remained with her about 3 months and then returned to her home. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, I'm sure at least some of you might have visited Taj Mahal in India. This is a beautiful structure and one of the wonders of the world. And this was built by King Shah Jahan for his wife, for his young wife, because as she was giving birth to her 12th child, she died. He could not accept it. So in memory of her, he built this beautiful structure. If you go and see inside, you will see the tomb. And many don't know that Taj Mahal itself is a tomb. But one of the wonders of the world because of its beauty and the marble that it has. And as we understand that this structure was built by the king in memory of his wife. He wanted to give a big gift to her, but this is a big gift that he gave to his wife because she had been with him, she lived with him as his wife for some years together, and this is the gift that he gave to his wife. And today, we are celebrating the Assumption of Our Lady. And Mother Mary gave birth to Jesus Christ. She accepted the will of God. And what kind of gift that God gave her for all her obedience, for accepting the will of God. And many say that God gave her the gift of assumption. And she was assumed into heaven. She was taken into heaven with body and soul. There's a reason we venerate Mother Mary, though many Protestant churches criticize us. We venerate Mother Mary and we respect Mother Mary. And the reasons are this. Mother Mary herself gave the reason for respect, for the respect that she gets, because she said, all generations will call me blessed, and the Almighty has done great things for me. Among all the women of the world, past, present, and future, she is the most blessed woman because she was chosen to be the Mother of God. There's a reason we venerate her, or we honor her in many ways. And secondly, Mother Mary is our Heavenly Mother, because from the cross, Jesus told John, this is your mother. And he told his mother, Mother, this is your son. And from that time, all the children of God became her spiritual children. And she became a spiritual mother to each and every one of us. That's the reason we venerate her. And thirdly, she is the model of all virtues in her obedience, in her prayer life, and in accepting the difficulties. And she always tried to fulfill the will of God. So these are the reasons that we venerate her. And in 1950, Pope Pius XII declared the dogma about the Assumption of Our Lady. And why should we believe this dogma? The first reason is that the uninterrupted tradition about Mary's death and Assumption, starting from the first century, it is not developed by the church. Even the apostles believed and they accepted the Assumption of Our Lady. There is a reason we accept this dogma. Even the apostles accepted this. The belief expressed in all the ancient liturgies of the church, they prayed to Mother Mary, and even the liturgies did address the Assumption of Our Lady. That is the second reason. And thirdly, the absence and veneration of the tomb of Mary, while most of the apostles have their tombs. And finally, the possibility of bodily Assumption were warranted in Old Testament, like Enoch, Moses, and especially Prophet Elijah. So these are some foundations for us to believe in the dogma of the church. And what can we learn from today's solemnity? The first thing is that Mother Mary is blessed with her Assumption because of her holiness. She always did the will of God. She prayed and she lived holy life. And that is the reason we know from the church's teaching, she was immaculate. She was even a sin, original sin did not touch her. So this is the reason that Mother Mary should be taken into heaven, and she is inviting us to live holy lives upon this earth, because when we live holy lives we will be blessed with eternal life. And she is the surety, and she is giving us assurance that we will be blessed with eternal life if we live holy lives. And secondly, we are given an assurance of hope in the resurrection and the source of inspiration during moments of despair and temptation. Dear brothers and sisters, today I am here representing the Sisters of St. Anne Congregation in India. And if you want to learn about these sisters, this congregation was started by a married woman. She was married to a Catholic man, and after having two children, her husband died of a disease. And she dedicated her life to God. She was very much interested in evangelization. And that is the reason she started a school. She started a boarding for the school children. And she continued her efforts to evangelize the people of God. And now, if you look at there are two congregations which are started by her. In one congregation, there are 1,000 sisters. In another congregation, there are 400 sisters. Totally, 1,400 sisters are working in this congregation. There are two, but in two regions, but which are established by the lady Jnanamma. Her name is Jnanamma. And after educating her children, she dedicated her life to the will of God. And today it is spreading, this congregation is spreading throughout the world. They are working in 6 different countries, including United States of America. And there are 8 sisters working in Kansas City. And they are working in a nursing home, which is run by the Archdiocese of Kansas. And coming to the mission work that they have different mission works, and one of their mission work is educating the children. And this these sisters have built a school in my village. If I'm here today amidst you, and if I'm really blessed, it is because of these sisters, because they came to our village, which is really remote. They came to our village 70 years back. They started a school, and they educated many children in our village. And now, the latest thing is that the children need English medium education, because there are multinational companies which are coming to India, where they need English as a main language, because communication is English in these companies. So learning English is must now to come to have to face the competition in today's world. That is the reason from this village, some are going out, those who are well-to-do families, they are going out to different towns to learn the English language, where they learn most of the worldly things, but not about faith and even about the Bible. They learn very little, even catechism is taught very little. And that is the reason these sisters have started a school in my village. And in fact, I was parochial vicar for Father Eric Ritter at Our Lady of Perpetual Help in Selma. I was with him for 3 years. I was his parochial vicar. And Father Eric Ritter visited the village Thalachiruvu last year, 2020 January. I'm sure those of you who are on his Facebook have seen all these pictures or videos with all the procession into the village. That's my village. So he visited this school, and he has been supporting this mission for some for last 3 years too. I informed about this mission, and he has been supporting it. Dear brothers and sisters, coming to know about the village, this village was built by a Catholic priest. The whole village was built by a Catholic priest. There was a missionary priest in my village in late 1800s, maybe 1890 or 1880, in that time. A priest was working in my diocese. He saw the poverty of the people. He was from Netherlands. He went to his town in Netherlands, brought money, and he went to the state government of India, and he bought more than 2,000 acres land, forest land, more than 2,000 acres forest land. And he went to different parishes, invited different all Catholics, come with me, cut the trees and make it a cultivable land. And so today it is a village with more than 6,000 population. And normally when we Google about India, Christianity in India, you will see 2.6%. But in general, there is almost 10% of Christianity in India. But on records is only 2.6, because many Christians, those who belong to scheduled caste and all that, they don't want to reveal their religion because they lose benefits from the government. And as a result, on the government records, it is only 2.6% of Christianity, but originally it would be 10% of Christianity in India. But if you come to my village, it has almost 90 to 95% of them are Catholics. Whatever the land that these Catholics own, all this land belongs to that priest or to that family. And his family visited almost 10 years back to our village. Dear brothers and sisters, so keeping this all in mind, the Sisters of St. Anne congregation have started a school with the aim of educating the children with minimum fee. First year, they educated 215 children. The fee was $15 per year, $15, $25, $35. Highest was almost $55, below 60 per year, per year. So last year, sisters educated 290 children, zero fee because of pandemic. Many people were finding difficulty and many difficult financial difficulties. There was no work and all that. So because of this reason, last year with the help of some donors, they educated 290 children with zero fee. And next year too, this coming academic year, they would like to give free education for the reason of pandemic, because many families are really struggling and there are many poorest of the poor in the village. And these villages depend on rain, and again they grow cotton and chilies or pepper, red chilies they grow and they sell. But there are many people who don't own any land, and that is the reason many people, those who don't have work, they're finding difficult. And sisters' aim was that to educate the poorest of the poor. But dear brothers and sisters, I would like to tell you one fact that we know in this country, if you want to educate a child in a Catholic school, it is costing from $5,000 to $8,000 in maybe below eighth grade. It's costing $5,000 to $8,000, which means for three children, if we take $7,000 as maybe one of the standard fee, so $7,000 with three children fee, let us say 21,000 or 20,000, we can educate almost 300 children in this school. 300 children, because sisters are managing it and everything they maintain. That's the reason, and even the cost of education is low there. And whatever the amount that we get here, it is going to be used for these children. Whatever the amount of that we get. That's why on this special day, on behalf of our Sisters of St. Anne and myself, I'm from the same village and I was educated by the same sisters. So on behalf of these sisters, I request you all to be more generous and to be kind. And on this special occasion, I would like to thank Father Eric Ritter for his continuous support to these children and to this school. But at the same time, I request you all, whatever you can, it may be little, it may be more, if God has blessed you with financial resources, please do support this mission. Even if it is $1, don't worry, because it's a big amount in India. With $1, we will get almost 70 rupees, 74 rupees there. It's a big amount there. That's why, please do not hesitate, even if you have little or more, whatever the amount you have, please be generous, and that is going to be blessing to many children in the village. Not only to this village, even surrounding villages, from surrounding villages, many children are coming for education in this school, because it is run by sisters and there is quality in education. And even fee for this year, it's going to be zero, so many would be coming. I'm expecting more than 300 children this year. And that's why those of you who can afford, please be generous financially. And those of you who cannot help, don't worry, but please pray for this mission. That is going to be a great help for this mission. And special thanks to Father Eric Ritter, Father Danny, and Deacon Robert, and to each and every one of you. And be sure that all these children will be praying for you and for your homes and for all your family members. May God bless St. Luke's Parish and each and every family in this parish. And God bless America. Amen. Please stand. I believe in one God, Father Almighty. His only begotten Son of God. Let us ask the Blessed Virgin Mary, who reigns in heaven for all eternity, to intercede on our behalf before the Lord.
For the Church, that we may continue to grow in holiness as we hear the Word of God and observe it as did Mary, the Mother of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For civic leaders and all those entrusted with creating policy, may the Spirit of wisdom guide their decisions. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who are pregnant, particularly those with an untimely or difficult pregnancy, that they may nurture the gift of life entrusted to them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the mission appeal we make today for St. Anne's congregation, may God bless all those who serve in their missionary work. And like Mary, be humble of heart. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
As we begin a new school year, may each of us strive to bring Christ into our world, imitating the Blessed Virgin Mary and taking on this responsibility. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who have asked for our prayers, especially those listed in our Book of Intentions, and those who have recently died, Ricky Alderete III, Michael Hunt, and Olivia Juarez. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the special intentions of this Mass, for the repose of the soul of Cynthia Flores Rodriguez, George Walling, Manny Lopez, and Richard Zamora. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all the prayers we hold in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Almighty God, you have blessed us with great things, and holy is your name. Come to our aid and grant the needs we bring before you through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Mm-hmm. blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, receive the bread we offer you, fruit of death and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of Lord God, we ask you to receive us and give us the sacrifice we offer you with a humble and contrite heart. Lord, wash in iniquity and cleanse me from my sins.
Thank you. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name.
For a good and good of all his name.
Let us pray. May this oblation, our tribute of homage, raise up to you, O Lord, and through the intercession of the most blessed Virgin Mary, whom you assumed into heaven, may our hearts aflame with fire of love, constantly long for you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For today, the Virgin Mother of God was assumed into heaven as the beginning and an image of your Church's coming to perfection and a sign of sure hope and comfort to your pilgrim people. Rightly, you would not allow her to see the corruption of the tomb. Since from her own body she marvelously brought forth your incarnate Son, the author of our life. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you and with joy we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving you thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when the supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving you thanks, he gave the cup to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with our Pope Francis, Gustav, our Archbishop, Mike Bullitt, and Gary, our auxiliary bishops, and all the clergy. Remember also, brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, especially those who died in our families. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with Saint Luke, and with all the saints of Israel throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all the glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by the divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us now offer one another a sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Christ. The body of Christ.
Pray this act of spiritual communion for our brothers and sisters who are not able to join us. And we pray, my Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Having received the sacrament of salvation, we ask you to grant, O Lord, that through the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary, whom you assumed into heaven, we may be brought to the glory of the resurrection through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for the announcements.
A reminder that we have the collection baskets at the exit. We have the second collection today is for the mission appeal for St. Anne's Congregation in India, the mission work that Father Tuma represents today. So please note that this week's second collection was moved to next Sunday, St. Vincent de Paul. Today we celebrate the mission appeal for Father Tuma. The Knights of Columbus are selling breakfast tacos. After Mass, let's see, this is the 10 o'clock. I apologize. I've done three Masses. This is the 12 o'clock Mass, so forget the tacos. On Thursday, August the 19th, the Oldies but Goodies Senior Adult Ministry is hosting a distribution of box fans in the parish hall from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. in partnership with Gonzaga Medical Group. This event will be held in a parking lot outside the parish hall. Next weekend, the Guadalupanos are hosting their sixth annual summer sizzling bingo on Sunday, August the 22nd at St. Luke Parish Hall from 3 to 6 p.m. All are welcome to come and enjoy the fellowship and enjoy the game of bingo. Finally, the weekend of August 21st and 22nd, Faith Formation begins taking registration for CCD and religious education classes. Please call the Office of Faith Formation or visit the parish website for registration. Today we have the traveling chalice going to Robert and Clarissa Gray. Will you come forward, please, at this time? Give a round of applause for the Gray family. And turn to the hymnal, the back cover. You'll find the prayer for vocations. And pray with me. God, in baptism, you call us by name and made us members of your people, the church. Guide us to know our vocation in life and to respond by living your spirit of holiness for your greater glory and for the service of your people. Raise up dedicated and generous members who will serve their lives as women and men, religious, priests, deacons, married or single. Send your spirit to guide and strengthen so that we may serve your people, following the example of your Son, Jesus Christ, in whose name we offer this prayer. Amen. May God continue to bless your family, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Give another round of applause, please. Do we have anybody here visiting St. Luke for the first time? Any anniversaries or birthdays that we're celebrating this week? A birthday here, another birthday over here. More birthdays are appearing back here too. A birthday? Father, can you honor us with a blessing?
Please extend our hands upon them as we pray. Lord, our loving Father, we thank you for the gift of life. And we thank you for all your blessings in the lives of these, your children. Lord, on this special day, as they're celebrating their birthdays during this week, we surrender them to care and love. Bless them abundantly with good health in mind and body. Bless their family members, their intentions, and their undertakings. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Well, mighty God, bless the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Happy birthday. Amen.
And finally, I want you to help me thank Father Tuma for coming and celebrating Mass with us. And for presenting to us the growth that is occurring in India. Thank you very much, Father, for your service. Please stand for the final blessing.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.